party people.
Welcome to The Breakdown with Nate and Johnny, back with another hot reaction. It's actually not a hot reaction, it's fucking cold today here in Australia. We've had a cold snap come through.
Today, I'm introducing Johnny to, well, you've already met Harry Styles.
Oh, imagine if we actually met Harry Styles.
I would feel so fucking insecure and so unattractive.
He's incredibly cool and good looking. Hey, so his brand new album, Harry's House, has dropped. I love the whole album. We like heavy metal, but we also like to listen to other things. So today, I'm going to be introducing Johnny to the first track of the album, Music for a Sushi Restaurant.
Yeah, look, I dig Harry Styles. I have liked everything that we've checked out. I've checked out a bit of his older stuff a while back. I haven't listened to anything of the new album because it only just dropped and I've been on tour all weekend. So I haven't really listened to anything new, but I'm keen to hear this.
The reason I want to show this to Johnny was that I feel like particularly this track is a little bit of a departure from what we've seen from the singles in the past, from like Watermelon Sugar High, Golden, Even As It Was. I feel like this is a little bit more Silk Sonic is the way I sort of described it to you before. Yeah. And we really like that. So This is just a visualizer. There's no actual music video here, but you're not going to need it because you can watch Johnny's face and he's very handsome. He's no Harry Styles, but who is?
I'm definitely not Harry Styles. But I am a kind of nice guy, so if you want to like and subscribe and hang out with us a bit more, that would be really cool. Follow us on the socials. If you want to help the channel out, you can check out our merchandise. You can also chuck even just a dollar or so in the donations link that we have. It really does help the channel out. You guys have been so absolutely incredible with supporting this channel and putting some dollars in our Dollary Do account. And we really do appreciate it because it affords us a lot of cool things.
So, yeah. Like lights for the background. Anyway, 3, 2, 1. Tell you what, good headphones. I haven't listened to this in good headphones yet. Oh, damn.
Production's cool. Okay, yeah. Oh, that panning,
that bass.
I feel like I'm actually like allowed to slap the bass now because I finally play the bass guitar.
100%, yeah. D player.
Yeah, fuck yeah. I want you. Cause I love you, babe. Every kind of does have a Silk Sonic vibe.
Dude.
Oh. Get sexy. So many cool little elements. So much going on in that production.
For what seems like, on first listen, a fairly basic, simple, there are so many layers and so many elements to this that are super fun. The thing I really like about it, it's not about him. His voice is there, but it's not crazy. It's not the forefront. It's not, look at me, I'm the star vocalist. This is just a really fun produced song.
And it's very songwriter driven in terms of the instrumentation of it. Like everything builds, there's always like constant layers coming through, an extra, you know, instrument here and there.
Yeah.
Everything builds and then pulls back and very, very cool.
Bass kills me.
Yeah, sick. That's cool. I just found out who it reminds me heaps of. Prince.
Yeah.
Heaps like Prince.
Was it because there was scat?
A little bit, but even just the the multiple layered, and he does a lot of that sort of stuff.
Yeah, 100%. You can hear this. It's like a really upbeat moment from like the original Batman soundtracks.
Yeah, yeah, fair enough. I'm not going to go wrong, staying cool. No, I'm happy,
just a taste, 'cause I love you, babe, in every kind of way, just a little taste, you know I love you, babe. I don't want to pause in the trumpets a bit, but you're right, even that guitar line's very Princey.
Yes. Prince-esque scream there.
Very cool. Fun!
So much fun.
Yeah, I think what I said about this album to you previously was that it is an album that's just, he's made the album that he wants to make, and it's not necessarily all about him as the I'm the star. It's he's making music because he wants to make the music.
Yeah, and to touch on and further on that it's not about him thing, like from a songwriter's perspective, it is a very bold but extremely well-executed move by him to have a chorus without vocals. To have without a chorus vocal, like without a hook.
Yeah.
Like, it's all about the music and just those accompanying like sort of...
Even his vocal style is that. It's really stripped back, almost whispered, like...
Yeah. But there's like a little bit of like, there's those little bits of like flair and flash that he puts in.
Yeah.
But it's all about the song. It's 100% about the song. It's fantastic songwriting. Very easy to listen to. Very fun and vibey.
So much vibe.
Yeah.
What do you guys think? For those of you that are new to the channel, welcome. I'm sure you're all Harry fans and you're a big fan of that. For those of you that are metalheads out there, how sick is that? It's so much fun. I love that. I think it's really exciting. So, man, I'm excited to see him play live. I reckon that'd be a hell of a show.
Dude, that would be amazing. Hey, if you are here and you're not a metalhead, see, we're not all doom and gloom. Maybe you want to stick around and check out some of our metal ones.
If not, that's okay. Love you.